I'm the scat man.
Fun wants to speak to you. Carl, what are you doing?
The new intro to Bootleg TV?
We had an entire year to come up with an intro for Bootleg, and this is the best that we've got.
Hey, I thought it was funny.
It's atrocious, Carl. Atrocious. Everyone's gonna laugh at us.
Isn't that kind of the point?
At us, Carl. Not with us. You better come up with something better. And turn the Walkman off. You're killing the show,
sorry.
Carl!
I don't know how it works.
It's on repeat.
Trent, did we film anything funny?
That was pretty funny.
Not helping.
Taking your ride. No. We have a 1099 and it's making good progress. I repeat, we are about to go in pursuit.
1098. Officer in pursuit. I've waited my whole life for this. Officer down.
Send in the big dog.
I'm saying is that Shia LaBeouf would have made a much better Jango Fett.
No, that never would have worked, okay? Because
what are you talking about? He would have been great.
Shia LaBeouf is basically Batman, but scrawny.
I guess he's got a point, but he could bulk up.
I mean, yeah, but he'd have that. Dude, what happened to you?
I don't want to talk about it.
Right. Well, I have to go make sure Fun cares again. Good luck with that.
So what do you think? You think Dwayne The Rock Johnson would have made a good Batman?
Fun, you need to come out.
No, Carl!
It's getting better.
Let me know when it's over.
Hey, is Fun in there?
No, wait your turn. Wait. I have an idea. Come with me.
Teachers, are you stressed out, overworked? Are you tired of answering questions? Then this is the product for you. Take a Number is our patent-pending product based off of a trip to the DMV. With Take a Number, you can take control of the pace of your class, if there is one. Take a look at this completely fictitious, dramatized scenario.
97?
This technique leaves you with more time for your daily routines, like planning.
Last call for number 17.
The effectiveness of Take a Number is based off the very simple technique of never calling their number.
I just gotta go to the bathroom.
Now serving number 97.
Yes, finally!
That's all for today. Make sure to file your application for a new number tomorrow.
No more questions and no more stress. You'll leave every day at 3:45 like you just woke up, and chances are you just did. With Take a Number, every period is planning period.
This is no indication of Mr. Funderburk's commitment to bell-to-bell instruction.
I'm just saying that I feel like the show is really starting to come together, you know?
Do I still need this number?
No, you need a new one. Have you guys seen where Fun went?
I think he went that way looking for you.
Right, I'm gonna go that way.
But can you look at this news package so Fun doesn't freak out?
What news package?
You should know these things, Carl. It's the news package we did like 2 weeks ago about 8th grade orientation.
Right. Can you guys show me?
Research shows that the transition from middle school to high school can be a difficult one. And so we started last year going to our 8th graders and delivering our information a little bit differently for them about how to be successful in high school.
Today's event was put together by Ms. O'Connor and Mr. Kelly to bring 8th graders into Allatoona so that they had the opportunity not just to hear about Allatoona, but to actually see it as well.
So we compiled a Google Doc that contained some suggestions for students who would represent Allatoona well. And as an administrative team, we narrowed down that list. And we had about 40 tour guides. We also reached out to all of our clubs and activities, athletic teams, and asked each of them to have some sort of display in the cafeteria.
The last thing that we did was having our seniors, six or seven of our seniors, speak to the eighth graders just about the things that were the highlights of their 4 years here, the things that they wish they had done differently, the things that they were really happy they did while they were here, and then give them a piece of advice that as they come in as ninth graders, every ninth grader should know as they come in.
Ultimately, we want our incoming ninth graders to be successful and familiar with the building, with the campus, with the students, the faculty, the hallways, so that they can be successful as soon as they enter high school.
Trent, you seen Carl?
I have no idea.
Thanks, Trent.
Sorry, Carl. He's scarier.
Carl, my office. We have sports next. You love sports. I'm saying was, it's not bad. There's still room for improvement, though. You better have a plan. Of course I have a plan. I always have a plan. Wayne?
Yeah?
I need to work late tonight.
But I have plans. It's Christmas Eve.
Listen, Santa Claus. It's February. I need you to work late tonight.
Fine, I need to make a call.
Hey. Yeah. I can't make it.
What?
We're on in 15.
I know. I'm sorry. I can't go out tonight.
Are you kidding me? We've had these plans for like 45 minutes and you're already canceling. Where are your priorities, Lane?
We're on in 10.
I have to go. This is not over. Lame.
She'll be fine.
Da da da. O'Hara. That's me. Hello and welcome to O'Hara DeMeco's Dating Advice Valentine's Day Special with me, O'Hara DeMeco. We have three callers on the line with some great questions and I'm ready to give them some great answers. Let's get this party started, shall we? Hello, caller one, you're on the line with O'Hara DeMeco's Dating Advice Valentine's Day Special with me, O'Hara DeMeco. What's your question?
I really like this girl, but I'm not sure how to ask her out. Any advice?
Of course I have advice. This is O'Hara DeMeco's Dating Advice Valentine's Day Special with me, O'Hara DeMeco. Are you sure you like her?
Yeah, I mean...
No, like, are you really sure? You see, the thing about us girls is you have to treat us like queens. You need to worship the ground that we walk on, and you need to be lucky to breathe the same air as us. And remember, if you're not groveling, you're not doing it right. Next caller!
Wait, you didn't answer my...
Hey, caller, you're on the line with O'Hara DeMeco's Dating Advice Valentine's Day Special with me, O'Hara DeMeco. What's your question?
Hey, O'Hara, I've had this dinner planned for weeks, but my boyfriend keeps making excuses as to why he can't go. What do I do?
Wow, what a relatable struggle. Caller, I know exactly how you feel. What a simple idea dinner plans seem. And you know what's even funnier? You spend so much time planning something, only for it to be obliterated by a single phone call. I mean, really, you could have at least told me in person instead of calling me before I had to do this stupid show. You're one room over, Lane. Or, you know, better yet, don't even make plans with me if you're just gonna cancel them an hour later. And you know who does that? Dirtbags, that's who. And furthermore, I don't even like working at this stupid...
So you staying late tonight, too?
What do you think? Fun even took the doorknobs off the inside of the Edit Bays.
What?
Yep. Oh, by the way, how'd O'Hara take the news? You think she...
Well...
You look ridiculous!
Not well, Trent. Not well.
You know, just tell Carl we'll run one of those fun teacher pieces. Fun eats that stuff up.
Yes! Okay, we just gotta find him.
Okay. Carl!
I've been right here the whole time, guys.
Well, what do we do now?
This class is called Event Placement Environmental Science, and the topic that we're doing now is called Human Footprint. What students are doing is they are learning how many earth or natural resources it would take to sustain their lifestyle. So there's a sheet that they fill out, and the questions are simply asking them what they do on a daily basis, how much energy they use. They're learning how to use natural resources in order to live while not depleting and destroying the earth.
This is Latin 1, and we are creating good luck charms. They're called bola, that the ancient Roman children used to wear. Way back in the day, my colleagues, Latin teacher friends, and I were looking for a way to make it really come alive for them. So at the beginning, when we teach them about names and how young children were treated, we decided to go ahead and make it come to life by teaching them how to create this artifact that we know that they wore. Since it's Latin 1, they haven't learned much yet, so really they're working through learning the distinction between gender inside of the language and how that mattered, masculine versus feminine. But they are learning now the customs and practices associated with babies and human life and how the ancient Romans valued that compared to how we do.
Well, it's actually a senior honors anatomy class, and what we were trying to do there was get the students accustomed to and ready for their use of the different utensils that they're going to encounter in their dissections. And one of the things I found in the past is if I just turn students loose on their biological samples like the heart or the liver or kidneys or brain without already having a pre-experience with how to use the tools appropriately, that their dissections just become sort of a hack and slash, a kind of a cut and slice deal. So we did this activity to get them familiarized with the tools. This is a lab actually that Ms. Ann Dodd developed back when she taught anatomy. And I adopted it and adapted it a little bit. But pretty much it's been her baby, and was a seminal activity that I observed her teaching in the classroom with, and thought it was an excellent way for the students to not only get used to the different body regions, body planes, cavities, but also to begin to do their very first dissection at the level of detail that we need to do in anatomy. It sort of piggybacks on some pre-learning that they did in terms of the different body cavities, body regions. We have different body planes. And then there's different incisions that can be made when you want to view the macro anatomy or the organ level anatomy. And so some of that material was learned via some group activities. We also took some PowerPoint notes, had a good kind of refresher quiz on that. And then this was sort of kind of bringing all of that knowledge together to be able to look at and demonstrate their knowledge of those different body regions.
You know, it's not my fault. Fun made me do it.
Carl!
Please hide me.
He's in here, Fun!
Thanks, O'Hara.
Thank you, O'Hara.
Carl, that was fantastic.
Okay, I can explain. Meredith came in and... Wait. fantastic?
Of course. Now it's time for the big finish. Remember, I never doubted you for a second. Always doubted you, Carl.
I should never have trusted Trent.
Carl, let's talk. Producing a show isn't easy, but I knew that you could handle the pressure. Sometimes you have to play the role of the bad guy for the benefit of the show. McPherson, can you grab me a little bit more volume? I'm really trying to drive this thing home. Thanks. Sometimes you're going to have to make decisions that are going to be unpopular with the rest of the crew. But deep down, they're going to respect you. Do you understand now, Carl?
Yes, I get it. I get it.
Aww.
Wait, you rewrote my ending.
Of course I did, Carl. Your ending was terrible.
Ugh.
I'm the Scat Man.
I'm rolling.
Book it. Book it faster.
Remember, I never doubted you for a second.
All I'm saying is that Shia LaBeouf would have made a much better Jango Fett.
No, what's that?